Welcome to GeoVis Plus channel. Today's section is about land suitability analysis using weighted overlay tool within Arc GIS software environment. Let's assume some portion of the land is suitable for agriculture as a hypothesis. But what portion of the land is suitable is the point of analysis for this video. Step 1. The first step is to reclassify your raster data to appropriate formats and make ready to use as input in the analysis. Reclassification tool of ArcGIS is used here. Our first constraint is going to be elevation. Let's classify it into categories. Based on various literature, some crop types prefer certain portion where an elevation some meters above sea level is taken. For instance, in Ethiopia, major crops such as teff grows between 1,800 to 2,200 meters above sea level, wheat grows between 1,000 to 2,300 meters above sea level, while barley grows between 2,000 to 3,500 meters above sea level. I'm inserting the last range values for each elevation ranges to this classification. Provide appropriate name where you won't forget another time you check it back. Only few characters are accepted here, that's why it's refusing several times. In the same way, reclassify for other constraints too. The biomass conditions based on vegetation indices are an important component of the suitability analysis. To consider the soil moisture conditions and related factors, soil adjusted vegetation index (SAVI) is included in the suitability analysis. River proximity is an important constraint that is considered in agricultural suitability. It determines the possibility for cropping during non-seasons, reducing the dependence on rain through irrigation possibilities. In the same way, classify for other constraints I have at hand as an input for agricultural suitability analysis. The river proximity raster file has some problem, so let's skip and work with three constraints for the sake of this video. Step 2. After reclassification is finalized, go to weighted overlay tool. Make sure you have enough references to decide which constraint will have how much influence and how to divide each constraint into various classes. Each constraints may have different degree of influence, but each constraints influences has to make 100 when added together. Finally, this result appears here. step 3 is about vectorizing raster file. Vectorizing is necessary for further GIS analysis. If the checkbox Simplify Polygon is checked on, the polygon might look better for visualizing. But it will affect the area calculation, so I skipped it. As you can see now, the vectorized polygon has a lot of data, but what we need is the suitability classes as one class. Therefore, using the dissolve tool is the best idea. Use the grid code for dissolving the shapes. Step 4. Now let's calculate the area of each agricultural suitability class. Note, agricultural suitability needs a lot of other constraints. We have used only 3 for the purpose of this video. I hope you are following the steps well. Apply appropriate mapping visualizations and produce maps. Make sure you change the view from data view to layout view. I will use the dissolved vector file for producing the map. Note, raster files directly can also be used in producing maps. Thank you. hope you liked today's video. Let us hear about your responses on the comment section. Don't hesitate to subscribe to this channel. If you need any support or other inquiries personally, you can contact through the link below.